Hey everyone, it's Alison. How's it going? Well, finally a glorious day so I can make a video today. And to celebrate National Recycling Week next week, I thought what better way than to reduce our recycling by making our own apple scrap vinegar. Now I've been keen to make this for ages, but I just never have enough scraps. But finally, after a preserving workshop a few weeks ago, I gave it a go. It's super easy and I think you'll love it. So what you need at least 1 kilo of apple peels and cores, otherwise it's not worth making it. And this is how much end liquid you'll end up with after using 1 kilo. So you can see it's not very much, so try to have at least a couple of kilo. Right, so here's what you need to do. Grab a clean glass wide jar, pop all your apple scraps into it, and generously cover it with cold filtered or boiled water. Add a couple of tablespoons of any type of sugar for 2 kilos of peel. That'll get the fermentation started. Give it a good stir, pop some muslin on the top, and then store it in a cool, dark spot ready for fermentation. Now, you'll notice it changes colour. There'll be a bit of foamy sort of action, yeasty action happening. That's all a good clue that everything's going to plan. Now, this first fermentation will take 2 to 4 weeks. And then when it's finished, which you can see this one now starting to be finished, it's slowly sinking and settling on the bottom. So next week I'll take this out and I'll strain it. I'll discard all the apples into my compost and then I'll add it into another bottle. Important that it's got enough space on the top, and secure it with muslin. And then that'll be an additional 2 weeks fermentation. And basically just keep tasting it until it tastes acidic enough to fit your requirements. So 2 to 4 weeks in here, probably longer in winter, and then possibly another 2 weeks in here. Stir it maybe once a week. Here you don't need to touch it, just give it a bit of a taste. And you can see the mother is starting to settle on the bottom and it's clearing quite nicely as well. It's not very strong, but that's okay. I don't want a very acidic vinegar. Now, if you can, I recommend never using white vinegars. Not only are they sold in plastic, but they're also diluted now, or imitation quite often as well. So you really don't know what you're getting. And the best way to have control over what you're cooking with or cleaning with is making your own vinegar. Now, this will be absolutely ideal as a cleaning agent around the house. And that's what I plan to do with it, because I'm never going to have enough apple scraps to make my own all the time. So that's super easy. I'll post some photos tomorrow of the various stages of the discoloring of the apples to give you a guide. And if you have any questions, just leave a comment or post on Facebook and I'll be happy to get back to you. All right, take care. I'll see you next time. Ciao.